Hello everyone and welcome back to Gear Adventures. So today we're going to be reviewing the Aipas F3 Adventure e-bike. Well, sort of, kind of. Let me explain. So I've been waiting for some big name models to be released. I was looking for some e-bikes that might be a little lower in cost that I could purchase and do a review on. I came across Aipas when I was on, I believe, Facebook and on Instagram, and they started popping up because I was looking for different e-bikes. And some of the stuff that I saw that actually came with was actually pretty cool. The F3, I saw it came with the dual suspension, 13 amp hour battery, and it had the 1500 watt motor. So there's a couple things about that bike that price-wise was actually very interesting to me. So I went ahead and pulled the trigger. I ordered it. I decided to go ahead and join one of the Facebook groups. There's the only one I could find out there for Aipas. Just because sometimes if you do that, it gives you a little more general idea or information about the bikes themselves, or you know, maybe issues or problems people might be having and stuff like that. So it didn't really take me long after joining that group to start to see people were talking about some issues they were having with like the motor, the controller. They were posting some videos, they were posting photos, and some of the issues they were having. Now, Aipas was actually responding in that group to them. And then I started seeing someone say that the bike they ordered didn't come with the right battery size. And Aipas was responding to that too. One of the responses was a horrible response. And it really made me start to question this company and who did I just purchase this bike from. Now, granted, the F3 isn't supposed to be released until the 1st of August. Right now, this video I'm making today, it's July 25th. But anyhow, I started seeing all this and it started to worry me a little bit, like, okay, what's going on? So I'll pop up one of the response to Aipas to one of the people that actually asked about the battery and what the response was. Now, after reading that response, I have to say I was sort of taken back, like, hold on, so you lied to customs to get bikes into the United States, or are you lying to the customer that's not actually the right battery size? So your guess is as good as mine, but that sort of did take me back a little bit, like I wasn't expecting that. So now, being a little concerned about what was going on, the following day I went on to check the F3 Adventure to see if the battery size still said a 13 amp hour battery, because that was sort of the battery that was in question with these other bikes that Aipas was making and releasing. They were supposed to be 13 amp hours and they were showing up of 11.8 amp hours, I think the stickers were saying. So I went on and I checked, and suddenly I noticed that the website itself dropped it from a 13 amp hour to a 12 amp hour, which again was alarming and a little concerning. And I wasn't sure if this was a direct result of what was going on with the other post that was on the group about the batteries being the wrong size. I did reach out in an email, and I also went on and posted in the group page about realizing this battery was a different size, but on all the advertising, it was still showing a 14 amp hour. They hadn't switched that yet. So Aipas did respond and said that someone made a mistake and that they were fixing it. But none of the other numbers changed on the length of the battery, like the miles were still the same. Everything was still the same. At that point, I decided, there was just too much going on. I went back to the Facebook group and all the posts that were on there were being deleted, including the one that I had made. So I went on and looked at the moderators, and the two moderators for this group are basically anyone that says anything negative. They're the gatekeepers. They go in and delete their posts. Since I have been banned from the group for calling them out on some of the stuff that they were doing with the batteries and stuff like that. They automatically banned me from their advertising page, so I can't even see their Facebook page because I was commenting on the advertising not being correct and that it was false, so they banned me from that. Just the experience not good at all. So I canceled the order on July 14th. They basically responded with that it was going to take them a long time, or not long time, they said it takes them a while to do the refund. And I asked them, well, how long? And they still weren't giving me a time frame. So back and forth a couple of times, I kept asking the same question. I need to know how long, 7 to 10 business days, what's it gonna be? And they just kept saying, well, it takes extra long and we're trying to process your return. That's where I'm at right now. Today's the 25th. I emailed them late last night again to ask them if my refund was being processed yet, and they haven't even processed it. And we're at the 25th. So it hasn't even started the process. So I don't know what they're doing or what kind of games are playing. I went to the Better Business Bureau, but again, this has just been my experience with Aipas. Also, right before they booted me from the group, there was a couple more people that were on there complaining about the issues they were having with the controllers, and they actually are not, like they were saying on there, they've been trying to reach Aipas and they're not honoring any of the warranties. So I actually started messaging some of these customers in private off of the group page, because I knew by making comments on the group that they were gonna ban me from there too. Just from talking with these people on the group page. So I have touched base with some of those people and they are still having issues. They're not honoring any of the warranties. They've gone silent on these people. They won't respond to them. They won't respond to emails. There's just a whole lot going on with this company. So basically, that's going to be my review of this bike, because I canceled my order, as I said, and I'm not getting the bike. I was really hoping to get this bike, get my hands on it and see how it is, but I think from doing a little bit of research and joining this group, I actually saved myself a huge headache with this bike. Now, granted, I haven't gotten my money back. I'm going to have to dispute it with my credit card to probably get my money back, just because it doesn't seem like Aipas is going to actually do anything. They haven't responded to the Better Business Bureau. They've reached out to them twice now and there's been no response. So I really don't know what's going on with that. But if you're in the market for an e-bike and you want to get something, yes, the Aipas comes out and it looks like it's a really good product. But yes, it might be just a little bit cheaper. But I would recommend you maybe look at some of the other bikes that are out there that are well known, like the Electric brand. Yes, they don't have the dual suspension and some of that, but that's also a decent bike for around the same price. So again, I don't know about this company. I'm just putting a warning out there to everyone. I don't really like to make a video like this. I really don't want to, talk about these types of things. I was wanting to make a positive video of the bike and showing some stuff about it, but instead, this is where we are. Save yourself a lot of time and a lot of headache. Stay away from Aipas. Just don't buy it. Just move on, go to something else. If you've had any issues yourself, please feel free to post in the comments below problems you've had, things that, issues that have gone on with the bike, how your customer service has been. I know there's some people that have gotten these bikes and were commenting how much they love them. One of those people actually were using one of the pictures from one of the members on there on their post. And then they also had contacted them about the issue with the battery not being the right size, and said something to them in a post, and it was like, hold on, they were acting like they're part of Aipas. So I don't know what's going on there. I don't know if they create fictitious accounts on Facebook. I really don't know. But anyhow, if you've had issues, problems, please post in the comments below. Let everyone else know what's going on with your situation. If you actually are having a good customer service experience with Aipas, please absolutely post that too, because you know what? Maybe my experience and some of these other people are just not the norm, but it just seems like there's a lot of it going on and it's all being deleted and wiped from their page so no one knows about it. So it's really messed up and I just want to make everyone aware. So hopefully this video has helped someone. Please hit the like button. This needs to be shared with other people so they know what's going on at this company. I screenshotted, obviously, as I've been showing the entire time, all this stuff going on, so that way I have proof and it wasn't just me saying this. So yeah, just, man, move on. Get something different. Hopefully I get my money back. I will update you later on about what happened with me and how this process ended. I'm hoping for a best case scenario, I'll get my money. But like I say, I might have to dispute it and go through all kinds of channels with that. So I hope this video has helped you out some, and I will catch you in the next one.